Tonight on The Probe, we focus our lenses on the minority political parties in Ghana. The quest for a third or even a fourth force remain a myth. Or am I wrong? I say a myth because of the abysmal performance of these parties and their candidates since the Fourth Republic. What could be accounting for your lack of confidence in these political parties or their candidates? Will you change the trend this time and cast your vote for them? We always hear people say, I'm tired of the NPP and NDC, yet they still get a majority, or rather, share the votes amongst themselves. All the minority political parties combined never cross at least 10% mark. How will the minority political parties get the chance when you never vote for them? Tonight, three of the flag bearers of these parties have agreed to be probed on how serious they are about becoming a third force, or are they in the race just to position themselves strategically in case of a runoff, or they are indeed in it to win it. They represent the neutral, nuanced idea, sometimes in between and other times far off to the realms of promises and talks, very alien to what you're used to from the NPP or the NDC. This is The Probe, live on the Joy News channel, Joy 99.7 FM, and affiliates across the country on DSTV. You can find us on channel 421, on GoTV, it's 144. Facebook, we are live, myjoyonline.com, we are live as well. Please, it's a good time to send your thoughts and your comments. Please stay with me, I'm right back. Thanks so much for staying with us here on The Probe, on the Joy News channel. Like I said, we're also live on Joy 99.7 FM. On Facebook, we are live as well. MyJoyOnline.com, we're also live. It's a good time to also contribute. Whatever it is, are your comments, your contributions, your suggestions, please send them via WhatsApp to us as well. And we'll definitely put them to our presidential candidates who join us in the studios tonight. And it's a good time to present to you the voices of those who believe they will cause a major upset in election 2020. To my immediate left is Mr. Percival Kofi Akpaloo. He's the flag bearer of the Liberal Party Ghana, LPG. And also in the studio is Christian Kobna Andrews. He's a Sofutri Abosom, as we call him. He's the flag bearer of Ghana Union Movement, GUM, he calls it. Welcome, gentlemen. And later on, via Zoom also, we'll have the All People's Congress flag bearer, Mr. Hassan Ayariga, joining us as well. And thank you very much for agreeing to be with us. You've taken time off your busy campaigning schedule to be with us tonight in the studio for The Probe. Well, Mr. Akpaloo, is this still Somiha? Not Somiha.
When you say LPG, then we respond, Yen Kong Kwan. And when you say LPG for the second time, then we respond, Somiha. Nesomeha.
Why? Why Somiha Nesomeha?
In Akan proverb, we say Bakufo Nchile Damfo. Unsum unsum so anwani nipa. So bring your ideas.
Okay.
I bring my ideas. We put them together and then we move this country forward.
Okay.
One person cannot do it.
Okay.
It should be collective stuff.
Okay. And GUM, we say what? Yeah, GMI.
Yes.
Okay.
The second one is Yebre.
Yebre. Okay, it's Ye GMI and Yebre. Okay, why in that order?
Just you bear witness to these things that is.
I saw also Bre and Sanawaji Omai, but it's the order that I'm.
No.
Okay.
GUM Yebre. GUM Ye
GMI. Oh, okay.
So, Yebre and Yebre GMI.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, you're welcome once again. And Mr. Hassan Ayariga will join us shortly via Zoom. But I mean, okay, I think Mr. Hassan Ayariga has joined us via Zoom. Welcome, Mr. Hassan Ayariga.
Good evening.
Good evening, and thank you very much for joining us tonight on The Probe. I hope campaigning is going well. Maybe it's a good time to start with you. How is campaign going? Because I've heard you say that people should waste their votes on APC.
Currently, I'm moving from Takoradi to Cape Coast. As you are, you can hear the sound of music and the campaign song on the background. So we are still campaigning. We are not on break, and as you are aware.
Okay, so we'll try and rectify the connection to Mr. Hassan Ayaraga. You heard him say that he's still on the trail. But Mr. Kofi Akpaloo, how has campaigning been like?
Oh, it has been very receptive. People have been receiving us very, very well everywhere we visited. And I can assure you, this election, I'll win the elections.
What's this Menchia incident that we heard about?
Oh, actually, it was just a miscommunication between the secretary of the Otumfo and then ourselves. So, basically.
But how is it that a presidential candidate like you, there will be that kind of miscommunication? If you're going to the Menchia, you are not too sure about.
Oh, actually, what happened was that they gave us a date and we got to Kumasi around, that was Tuesday, around 11 p.m. Mm-hmm. And then the secretary called me to tell me that it's unfortunate that that day and then the next day is going to be Otumfo's soul day. And when it's a soul day, they need to bathe the soul.
Okay.
So it's not possible that we'll be able to meet Otumfo. But already we had sent a communications to our supporters that will be going to Menchia. So in the morning, around 10 o'clock, I got information that some of them have been at Menchia already waiting for us. So I needed to go there to take them away from the place.
Oh, okay.
That was the whole thing.
So it's not like you were just sacked?
Oh, no. No, you see, me, I vote at Menchia, Menchia South precisely, where Otumfo is. And Otumfo, he likes me. I'm one of the guys that he likes so much. So it will be, because he has always been asking me, when are you coming to see me? And so it's not like he doesn't want to see me. It just that it happened at the wrong day.
Okay. Well, Sofo, how are you juggling church and campaigning? Or are you still preaching the word of God?
I'm preaching the word of God at the same time going out to campaign to just let people be aware of the things that I have for Ghanaians. And the manifesto, as you all know, that I have to let them know. And the calamities that are before us now, things are very bad throughout the country. And people are responding to even the things that I've been saying. A number of people that have been following, I've been visiting chiefs and the queen mothers all over to let them be aware that they're supposed to be part of the ruling of this very country. But it's rather unfortunate that these very politicians have used a means of entrenching in the constitution that they are banned of active politics, which is a wrong thing that we need to bring them on board for us all to come together to build this.
You think that chiefs and queen mothers should partake in active politics?
We have
so
to do that.
So it's one thing that you're going to change in our constitution?
Yes, I want to change it in our constitution.
Why so? Because they have to be independent?
No, it cannot be that. You see, if you want the country to progress, and these people are the custodians of the land, and you are telling them that they shouldn't involve themselves in the progress of this very country, how can it be? In the beginning, during, before even this very politician came to being, the kings and the chiefs who were ruling this very country, they were taking care of their villages and their distant. They were having meetings of the folks of the town. Communal laborers and the others were being done over there. But since the inception of these very things that they brought in the constitution, they have just been relaxed. So when you go there, you see all the priests are deprived because the tools that they have been collecting have been sent to government chest. And even before they get somebody to come and help them to make their gutter, they have to write and plead to the government before they get it. Of which I want to break that very thing, and I want to change that very situation for them so that even every toll that we collect from that very place will be given to the chiefs, the pastors, the Muslims coming together, forming an association over there so that they will develop their own area. So if every town or village, the toll that they are collecting is not coming to the government, but they rather take it to develop their area, just it will take just a year or two, everywhere in the country you see a development.
Mm.
But when it goes to the government side, do you see what is going to happen is that the chief executive go to the weekend, he takes 10,000 for funeral, this one takes 2,000 for TNT, this one. So we are eating our own eggs.
Mm.
So we cannot see any progress in this country. That's why I want to involve them so that we can have a clear development.
But what has been their response so far?
Oh, really, really, they are happy because they know that that was the actual way of developing the country. But it seems these politicians, they are so crook, I'll put it that way, that they know that if a chief or a king be part of these very active politics, whatever the chief will tell the folks of the town, they will listen to them. So if they do something wrong, that they will not get any support from that place. That is why they abandoned them, not to be in
that. But it's interesting that you've already started calling politicians crook, but you are now a politician as well.
I'm not a politician.
I'm
a man of God.
Okay.
That I want to save this very country from the hands of these people.
But by now, God may have spoken to you about it. What is God saying?
About the election.
Exactly.
Oh, I'm going to win this election by 65%.
65%?
65%.
That's what God is telling you.
Yeah, I'm going to win this election by 65%. Afun Lanado is going home. Let me tell you one
thing. About the same Lanado that you said their party is going to be in power for 40 years.
But they just edited everything. I started by saying that Mama should prepare. Because he's going home.
Mm-hmm.
Nanadu is coming to stay.
Mm-hmm.
If Nanadu comes to power and did what God wants him to do for the country, he did everything right, he will stay in for 8 years. And after that, Baumia can continue. This one can come to about 40 years. And God created my kind to come on this earth, not to become a mad person.
Mm-hmm.
But if you don't take care, you'll be mad.
Okay.
God said, Moses, I want you to take these people to Cana. But Moses was not able to reach Cana because of what he did. That is what Nanado have done. You see, Nanado studied in London. US people, they engineered overthrow of Kwame Nkrumah. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
Republican, this is their flag.
Mm-hmm.
This is the United Kingdom.
Yes.
And this is the US.
Mm-hmm.
They have the same colors of the color of MPP.
Mm-hmm.
They have the same ideas of the MPP. And the Donald Trump, the Republican, they have this elephant,
mm-hmm.
and he's gone. So Ronaldo is following the suit. All of them bearing the same elephant. Mm-hmm. Donald Trump, one term,
mm-hmm.
is gone. Nanadu is going to follow the suit. Mm-hmm. You see, we thought God brought Donald Trump to save America. Not knowing that he came and did things that were very worse. This is what is happening in Nanadu's time. Nanadu, if you want the biggest liar in this country is Nanado.
Why? I thought adults don't call each other liars.
Why did he come out to tell us that when I come, I'm going to reduce petrol? It has not been reduced. When I come, I will see to it that every village will have a borehole. It has never happened. When I come, every district is going to have one district, one factory. It has never happened. When I come.
One district, one factory, you're saying it has never happened?
Oh,
it's underway.
You've one seen district, the one factory.
I'm sure you've heard about Eku Juice.
How many Eku Juice?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my dear.
Mm-hmm.
How many districts do you have in the country? So many districts in the country, which is 230 something. And you are coming to tell me that Eku Juice.
Amongst others. It's not just
Eku Juice. My dear. That is someone's business.
Okay.
You're saying we need government-owned enterprises.
Mm.
You have to prove to Ghanaians, this is what I have done. So we can learn from what you have done for our country.
Okay.
All the youth in this very country are just roaming about. We just need them to get to work, employment. And you are giving your own children's destiny into the hands of somebody to care for them. How can it be possible? We need to bring government-owned enterprises, state-owned enterprises, like the rice mill.
Okay, I'm sure we're getting into the policies. We'll get into it proper. I'm sure that you have a number outlined that we'll be getting into. Mr. Akpaloo, I was also asking you about, you know, you've heard Mr. Andrews raise issues about his campaigning on the ground and his interaction with the chiefs, for instance. I would want to find out quickly the response to your campaign whilst you've been on the ground, because it appears that we haven't heard much when it comes to campaigning. At least you're visible in terms of your vehicles and all, but what really are you doing and what is the message out there in terms of your campaigning?
Actually, our style is different.
Okay.
Our campaign style is different. We are not following the MPP, the NDC, the way they've been doing. Our own is a new way of doing campaign. Actually, we go straight to the young guy on the street, the woman in the market, and then we talk to them. And we share our message with them, and they are buying into the message very, very well. Every place that we've gone so far, the people have received us very, 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 very well. And as I'm talking to you, my team is in the Volta region, Pando, precisely. And I think they just moved to Hohoi. They just passed Alabanyo, so they are to...
Have you been there yourself?
Oh, yeah, I've been there myself.
Okay. And,
I'm supposed to be there, but because of this program, and then also tomorrow's debate organized by the NCCE, so that's why I decided to stay behind and then allow them to... So I'll join them on Tuesday morning.
And what do they tell you in terms of the responses to the message that they put out there? What exactly is the message?
Well, actually, the message we are giving to the people, is that what you're asking? We are not saying much. Very simple, straightforward. Every child, because the way my children are enjoying in Europe, we now have 6 children. 3 boys, 3 girls.
And they're all in Europe?
Yeah, they're all, because I gave birth to them over there.
Okay.
And every month they receive child benefits. So I want to do the same thing for the case in Ghana here. So every child in Ghana, when I become president, every month, each child will receive 200 Ghana cedis. And then, as those who are twins will receive 300 cedis per child.
Okay. And then, triplets?
Oh, 300 cedis per child.
Twins? 300, triplets, 300.
And so far as whatever, 300 per child.
Okay.
So if you have quadruplets, that will be 4.
400.
So that will be 1,200 every month. And then also those who are above 18 years but unemployed will receive unemployment benefit. And then those who have never worked before, they will receive what you call income support.
Where would that money come from?
Yeah, we'll create the money.
You create it.
Yes, we create the money. You know, we believe in positive money. We believe in positive money. We believe in sovereign money. And we believe that it's not only taxes that you use to run an economy. So you have to use ingenuity, creativity, innovation to move things up. So when I become president, especially the young people who want to learn a trade, like maybe somebody want to learn a seamstress or what do you call it? Hairdressing and so forth, we'll take care of their course as suited their training. And when they are done with the training, we'll give them loans to start their own businesses. And we've seen a lot of young graduates out there. We have a lot of programs for them. One of them is that we're going to set up a $10 billion job fund. So if you are a graduate and you want to go into business, just come for a loan and start your own business. And we also have an arrangement whereby there will be options that if you want to engage maybe a newly graduate, we will make sure the employer contribution, SNET contribution, government will take care of it for the first 3 years for the first 3 years that you employ that new graduate. And then also another option is that If you employ a newly graduate, if you spend, let's say, 100,000 on that graduate, when you are preparing your annual returns, we give you the option to write it 3 times so that it will reduce your tax burden, just to give incentives to employers to employ more people. We are a liberal party. We believe in lower taxes. We believe in entrepreneurship. So we want to support more people to go into businesses because government cannot employ more people. So the best bet to do is to empower the locals to go into businesses, building factories here and there. So support them to establish their own businesses. If you can get 1 million new entrepreneurs and each person is able to employ 2 or 3 people, you're creating about 4 million jobs. So the idea is that we want to create jobs. We want more people to get themselves engaged.
And that has not been done so far, you would say?
Oh, actually, their predecessors, or maybe the current government, they have done what they can. We can afford them. That's what they think they can do. But we believe that we can do far, far better than what they have done.
Okay. Let's see if Mr. Hassan Ayarga's line is pretty much stable now. He's joining us via Zoom. Mr. Ayarga, so I was asking you earlier that apart from asking us to waste our votes on you, what exactly is the message? I'll take that quick one from you, then we head to the Northeast region where I'm picking up information about some violence up there.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, much, much better.
Hello.
We can hear you now, Mr. Okay. Ayarga.
Thank you. Like you said, we have a lot of policies. For us in the APC, we've been going around. And clearly, what we have identified is that the millions of Ghanaians out there are tired of the NDC and tired of the MPP. So when you approach them, look and see if they've been waiting for you all these years to come to them and talk to them. You go around and you look at Market Square. It's like a football park that people have just put sticks and put up canopies in order to have a market. In the 21st century, these are the kinds of market we have. You go into that kind of market, there's no water, there's no electricity, there's no toilet facility, there are no, fire service. So if you go around this country, you will be disappointed in the leadership of the NDC and the MPP. You might be looking at Greater Accra and Greater Kumasi to think that that's the only development that they have done. Yes, that is the only development they have made. Elsewhere in other constituencies and regions, is catastrophic. I'm telling you, I have been to several villages so far. As I speak to you, I am on my way. I have seen very, 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 very bad situations of how people live. That in communities that you think they have water, they do not have. In communities that you think that there must be a clinic, at least a clinic, they don't even have. Let me talk of hospitals. In a community where you think that there should be toilet facilities, these people go to the bush to eat themselves. In a community where you think that they should be drinking water for the people, there's no water. So I ask myself, what are these two political parties vying for? What are they campaigning for? Are they campaigning just to win elections and mismanage our resources? Or are they campaigning because they feel like they have the majority and they can win elections? For me, I think the time has come for Ghanaians to do away with the NDC and do away with the NPP and then look for a third option. The APC is proposing that. I know other political parties like Mr. Goom in the LPG are also proposing. But they can follow suit as an Ayarga and learn a bit because I know they are. My good friend Kwabena is a pastor. He just mentioned that he's a pastor. We need real politicians to manage this country. We need people who have the ability, who have the strength, who have the know-how, who have the intelligence and the policies to be able to govern this country and change the lives of Ghanaians. We are not going to test any leader anymore. We've tested the NDC, they failed. We've tested the MPP, they have failed. And we do not want to test another person. We want people who have track records, who can run this country and make this country a better place. APC has a lot of policies, starting from the national data system, starting from the National Development Plan, looking at the Ghanaian First policy, looking at trying to retrieve all back all our resources that have been given out to foreigners to mine and to manage. We can manage our affairs. We don't have to give our oil sector mining sector, the diamonds, the bauxite, the oil, the cocoa to the foreigners, and making our boys and girls the 21st century slave in their own country. What else are we managing? We are managing only the political front. That's all we are managing, and maybe probably the media, you and the rest of the media crew. That is the only thing the Ghanaian people are managing. How can we be that clueless that we give up every resources of ours to the foreigner to manage while we look as if we are beggars in our own country? Mm. I haven't seen it anywhere that countries will give out their resources to foreigners to manage. And we are only interested in 10%. The 10% is what allows us to give out our resources and our natural resources to the foreigners, just the 10%. That level of corruption has gone too high, and that level of corruption must go low. So APC is proposing a national data system that will capture every Ghanaian right from the childbirth, right from childbirth till the last old man standing, to give us a perfect picture of how we live, how what we do, how we earn money, what work we do, and all that. All these information, once captured, will give us a perfect information of how the Ghanaian people live and survive.
Well, we'll interrogate some of the issues that you're raising shortly. It's The Probe here on the Joy News channel. We begin with the first batch of questions. A number of them, I'm swamped by them. Via WhatsApp, you can send it via 0540109009. We'll start off from Facebook. This one is from Kosimak Blonana. It says, number three is the main man. If Ghana was manufacturing everything we need and now can't manufacture. Okay, so I didn't finish that. I just lost it. But Adumako Job is also saying, Sofuchi Abusum is contesting for the president of Ghana, but he hates Abusum. Ghana, too, is a country for all these people. Will he still be a president for them, or will still cast them away? That's Adumako. We have this one from WhatsApp. Araba is asking, please ask Sofuchi Abusum about the prediction that he will come third in the polls. So some questions there. Okay, we'll stay a while longer on WhatsApp. It says, why should we take you seriously? That's from Oreku. Also via WhatsApp. It looks like it's a question for all three of you. Okay, and Fifi says, Hassan Ayarga, apart from asking us to waste our vote on you, what exactly is your message and where have you been campaigning? I think he's been speaking to that a while ago, and we'll get some answers. It looks like a number of them for you, Sofuchi Abusum. So he's asking that you have a problem with Abusum, and how are you
that
going
one,
to...
For that one, those who are tired of seven girls, idols, that they invite me and destroy them. If you think your idol is helping you, you can continue to serve them.
Mm.
You see, when we continue to borrow, take money from foreign countries, then you'll be choked. This very country will not see any progress. Our aim is to revive the old factory, which has been abandoned, especially the rice factory, rice mills, and that of the sugar factory, the cotton factory, Esukare, and that of Kumasi shoe factory, and the others. We need to bring all these things on board so that we can create employment for our youth. And at the same time, also help them to progress in their life. When we talk of old age benefits, which we want to bring, our mothers and the old men, they are 1060, they don't work anymore. Now, some of them don't even have children. So the government is not paying any attention to look after them. But we, when we come to power, we are going to give them at least a token every month. Okay. They'll take. We are going to scratch off every tax, toll tax, and that of the VAT and everything. It is not that very tax.
How are you going to do that?
We are going to remove all these things from the country.
And then replace it with what?
We are going to replace
it with a country without taxes.
But, yeah, oh, but we're going to tax those foreigners that are doing companies and that we're going to tax them, but not the market too.
Okay.
This market too, the small business, they don't even.
It's already
their capital.
It's been removed.
Oh,
it's been removed. Kayaks are no longer.
They take it and the others. We are going to remove them. Freeport is going to be brought into the country. Togo don't have anything, but they have a Freeport. Mm. We are going to do the same. You understand? Now, when we come, we are going to abolish this prime rate tax and the others. We give enough support for our youth to cultivate their land.
Mm.
The natural resources, which is within the gold. When we get gold, we just refine them and give it to the white people. They buy them. We use it in our country.
Mm.
Instead of we going for a loan. Loan for what? You see, when America saying they own China, they didn't go and correct their papers. They go in, train an airplane, this and this and that. So if we want anything from American people, take my gold or my cocoa and give me airplane.
You're going to into a barter system.
Excellent.
Okay.
Instead of going to correct cash, American dollar or pound sterling, for what?
That's how can I steal this thing
in my country?
Okay.
For you to bring your papers to me, for what? Mm. I don't need it.
Okay. So there was a question that was directly asking about the predictions that you're going to be paying. You said you are going to be 65%.
Yeah. Those who did that prediction, where are they? The Legon people even came out to say that they did not do it.
But there was a recent poll that put the president
They were MPP colors in their hearts.
Who?
Oh, those who did that prediction.
The University of Ghana.
They were MPP colors in their hearts.
And the CDD?
The CDD. I've not seen any CDDs this prediction. Me, they are human being.
But the University of Ghana one that you've seen, you think that they are MPP?
Oh, they wear MPP colors in their heart and they decide to do it.
Okay.
As my man too is wearing MPP color at the same time putting.
Mr. Akpalu is wearing MPP.
So the same putting.
Mr. Akpalu, you are wearing MPP colors.
Somehow, even I went to meet him on the program. He said, "And Ronaldo will come first. I'll be second." And did you say it? Is it not true?
You see, you come here. And then all your analysis that you are giving now, the people are watching, they are listening. Because you see, me, I don't want to play that game, you understand? Because I'm too big for these games. But what
are you wearing? He's accused you.
Oh, no, I don't need to answer this because, you know, I'm wearing.
Because the alliances, if there's a runoff, who are you going to support?
You see, I'm wearing LPG, okay? And then I have every right. Okay, to support my party.
Okay.
Because I founded the party and I built the party. Mm-hmm. I did not go and stand somewhere and say that MPP will be in power for 40 years. But you said you are 40. You no, he's a pastor. You say he's a man of God. God gave him a vision.
He explained.
No, he said God gave him a vision. Uh-huh. And then in the vision, MPP is going to be in power for 40 years. But you remember, we see, we have a lot of false prophets in this country.
Oh, but
one of them is him, and then
he's a false prophet.
And then that all those guys, you see.
You're saying he's a false prophet.
Yes.
Why is he a false prophet?
Yes, because he said that he saw in the vision and Akufo-Addo will
president. Come to power.
No, he said Akufo-Addo.
And he came.
No. You said it after he won. Now that Akufo-Addo has won, he will be in government for 8 years.
No.
And then after that, Bawumia will follow. Another MPP will be in power for 40 years. And then within a short while, MPP has not even been in government for 5 years.
Mm-hmm.
But you came back
because
to tell us that, God
you are
is telling
them.
You should come
because
and be a president.
They are not.
No. How can you be a president? Mm-hmm. Okay? How can you be a president?
Mm-hmm.
And then we entrust this country resources into your hand to manage. Mm-hmm. Whilst you don't even know your left from right. Because one, you are sitting here, you are saying that when you come, you're going to revamp the old factories.
Yes.
Abandoned factories.
How are you going to revamp them? You need money to do that.
But he's just
I'm coming. You need money to revamp them. You are sitting here and you are saying that when you come, you're going to abolish taxes.
Yeah.
Okay? One, you're not going to borrow. Two, you're not going to get tax revenue.
Mm-hmm.
So how are you going to get money to revamp them? And you're saying that it's not going to be private sector driven. Mm. You said it's going to be government driven.
So I want to know where you're going to get that money from to do that.
Can I explain?
And then you start here by saying that, oh, you dig the gold and then you go and sell the gold to the white people.
That's your barter system.
No, but the white people, they're already in town. Mm-hmm. Okay, they are controlling 80% to 90% of our gold resources.
Going to buy them.
He says that's not going to happen again.
No, you see, when you assume power, okay, you can't just do anything, okay, because you have laws governing this country. Somebody has entered into a contract with the country.
You know how to go about it.
You can't just go and then just abort somebody's contract. Mm. You can't just cancel somebody's contract. Mm. That's not how we govern. Okay, this is not like maybe in your church place where you are doing one-man church, whereby you can...
Is he doing a one-man church?
Oh, yeah, because he is the owner of the church.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. You know, these are some of the people, when I become president, yeah, he will file his annual tax return.
You are going to tax the church?
No, he will file his annual tax return, personal. Him personally, and then the church, okay? If it's a limited liability... Mm-hmm. If it's a limited liability, the church will file a tax return. If it's not a limited liability, but a limited by guarantee, company limited by guarantee, with that shareholding, then it means the state property. So that one will have a charity status.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? But still, will be compelled to file an audited account.
Tell Mr. Pelu that see, the church have built a university. The
okay.
Church
have built a it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. So, because you have gotten your way. You guys have gotten your way. You have gotten your way.
What has he done?
You have gotten your way.
I just want to ask him. What has he done for the country?
Forming a church and then selling oil.
And then collecting. And I'm going to be a president over here.
No, no, form a church. Form
he
a
says
church.
He gave birth to them out.
Oh, yeah. It doesn't matter.
No, you see, form
your
a church. Form a church.
And you are
and then,
looking for.
Putting fear in the people. No. Putting fear in the people.
He's putting fear in the people.
Yeah, that's what they do. They put fear in the people and then they sell oil to them. Okay, they sell water to them. They sell cocoa to them.
So you sell those.
You see, if that is how.
So
if that is how I want to make money.
Go ahead and do the same thing.
So for you do that.
But I don't
want
to
do.
I don't want to use.
You see, let me tell this
to make money.
Then
I don't want to
use
dubious means to make
today
money.
Today, if you didn't come,
because you see,
and
the church that you are running.
But I want to tell you,
you are using dubious means.
He to is a fake
to state this.
I would have to hear one at a time.
You see, you know.
Because he's a fake man. He has not contributed a quota to the progress of this country.
You know,
what has he done in this country?
If
you ask him, what have you done in this country? You have not contributed anything.
But you are in the church, you are stealing the old woman money, you are defrauding them.
And when I defraud them, I put the money,
because
the same money.
You defraud them.
He claimed.
No. But you can't be saying that. You have evidence to back that he's stealing from them.
This man.
Is going on
maybe,
in this country, are you not aware?
Maybe, what am I aware
what,
of?
What they are doing.
Maybe, what are they doing?
They lie to the old
maybe,
man.
Maybe
they lie
right
to the
now,
old man.
Right now,
then
you don't even have a house
in them.
He has done next to nothing in this country. How can you be a president?
And then you take money from the people.
You have not done next to nothing.
It's not right. Mm. You are stealing the from the vulnerables.
Okay.
You are sitting here, you have your children now.
You are
coming to be a president.
And then somebody comes to you.
And you tell us
as a church, okay? When Jesus Christ was alive, was Jesus Christ collecting what do you call that fee?
What?
Consultation fee.
Consultation. Mm.
Jesus Christ.
People were going to Jesus Christ. Was he asking them for consultation fee? You are here as a man of God. Somebody who is claiming that you want to come and serve this country.
Mm-hmm.
You are sitting somewhere charging people 500 series for consultation fee.
Yes.
For spiritual direction.
Okay. And when they
which
come, when they come, they give a testimony that they are here.
No,
which when
so,
they come,
so that's what happens.
They give a testimony that they are here.
You know, they are making the vulnerable society.
Yeah, they are here.
Okay,
and you are children are abroad, and you are coming to rule some people children
okay.
In this country.
Well,
no.
Okay.
Are you a serious person?
Okay, so
see,
how can you leave your children abroad?
I don't dwell on this.
Easy, I can't hear you both at the same time. I can't hear you both at the same time.
You cannot,
Mr. Andrews. I can't hear both. Okay, let me go on the phone line. Let me go on the phone line and bring in Mr. Hassan Ayaranga. I haven't heard from you much because we had a terrible connection to your line. So there were some questions that came in whilst we were trying to reconnect to you. One asking why we should take you seriously. It was for all three of you, and that's generated all that. But let's hear from you. Why should we take you seriously is a question. Okay, so it appears that Ms. Ayariga, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, so there's a question from a viewer who is asking, why would she take you seriously?
I mean, over the years, we've seen that of the NDC and that of the NPP, their style of leadership, and what has it yielded? What we see is that an economy that has borrowed $39 billion with nothing to show. What we see is that the Kenyan economy has gone down on its knees. What we see that we do not have schools, proper schools to educate the youth. What we've seen over the years is that we have seen youth unemployment increasing by the day, and we are producing graduates that are not creative and innovative and cannot fit into the 21st century. Mm-hmm. What we've seen is that we have abandoned the culture and tradition of the African people, and we have taken over the Americans and the youth life, and we are not producing enough to feed our country. We're not manufacturing, we're not industrialized. Over the years, we've been dependent and dependent on donor and dependent on borrowing and dependent on aid. We cannot continue to have mineral resources, natural resources, oil, gas, and all that I've mentioned earlier on. And then we give it out to foreigners, and then we expect to have sustainable and economic growth.
Okay.
We are saying in the AP, let us see us, because all these have enumerated. We are coming to solve that. As an area is going to introduce a national data system that will capture information of every
generation,
from
right
from birth to the last person standing. We are going to integrate a national development plan that is going to be linked to our national data system that will transform this country via our information. And we need to have a country that is data driven, not a country that believes in borrowing and believes in dependency. This you should take us here. We are coming to transform and restore back hope. Politicians have made us believe that without them, we cannot survive. But they are the ones inflicting the problem and the pain to many Ghanaians, those who are suffering. It is as a result of mismanagement and corruption. Mismanagement alone has taken a chunk of our resources. Corruption has taken the rest.
Okay.
So we have borrowed much and nothing to show, no roads, no hospitals.
But Mr. Ayariga, briefly, all this, you've been speaking about it earlier, especially the national data. Really, how much is it going to cost? Have we put cost to it? Where is the funding going to come from?
Why do you always ask for funding for my new team? How much is it going to cost to have a data system and put up registration centers across Ghana?
Mm-hmm.
Less than $5 million to $6 million.
Okay.
And you are asking me how we're going to fund it. If we cut down corruption, we'll fund it. If we increase productivity and cut down and increase manufacturing and have an industrial hub. If we put up an every environment for businesses to thrive, they will pay taxes, we'll find it.
So through taxes and all.
If we take over our mineral and natural resources to manage it ourselves, we'll find it. So as for funding, it's not just a problem at all.
Okay.
What is the problem is that mismanagement has made funding very difficult for many people to understand that we have resources. What the problem is that corruption has made us to understand that everything we ask for funding. Funding can be done when we cut down corruption, when we cut down mismanagement, when we begin to produce, when we begin to manufacture, when we begin to industrialize. That is resources coming and circulating in the system.
Let me take a quick break at this point. My final break for tonight. Then we can wrap up. It's just getting interesting. But let me take a quick break here on the probe. I'll be right back. Thanks for staying with us here on the probe. This is the probe here on the Joy News Channel. We are back, gentlemen. We are back.
This man
is kind of suffering.
To the whole world, that apart from his wife, he doesn't have any.
Where is this one coming from?
No, Mr. See, Akpalu? Because I have a lot of information.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, what is the information?
That
what
he has so many girlfriends. Okay,
he's a man of God.
No,
no, Mr. Akpalu.
Let me come out to say something.
Emefa,
For this, him being
this
a man of God,
is not a serious man at all.
No, he's a fake pastor.
Ghanaians shouldn't take him serious. Mm-hmm.
He's a fake pastor.
He's a person that he's following MPP.
Mr. Akpalu, please. You started by saying no, gentlemen. Wait, Mr. Andrews, wait.
We are going to
Mr. Andrews, Sofu Chiabosum, please, yes. You have to listen. Hey. I'm in charge of the show. You can't do this.
Yes,
we have to we have to listen to one person at a time. And you mentioned, Mr. Akpalu, that he can't be attacking personality.
Yeah, because
but that's what you're doing
me.
Now.
No.
And so let me ask the question.
I have a lot of information about him, that he has so many girlfriends. Yeah.
Can you prove one here? No, gentlemen.
What I'm trying to say is that me, I did not come here to attack him because that's none of my.
But that's what you're doing now.
No. Because he first asked.
You said you have your children.
So let me ask the question. We are wrapping up. So in the event that there's a runoff, Mr. Akpalu, please. In the event that there's a runoff, Mr. Andrews had mentioned that he's going to win this election by 65%.
Yeah.
That's what he said. I don't know by how many percentages you are going to win, Mr. Akpalu. But in the event that there's a runoff, who are you going to give your support to?
We're going to continue to vote until Jesus Christ comes. I am not going to add my this vote to whether NDC or MPP, any party at all.
Okay.
Because they are a group of people that I think they don't think of the country. They only think of themselves.
Okay. That's a brief one. But how are you funding your campaign?
Myself?
Yourself?
Yeah.
Where's the money coming from?
Oh, but I started life, it's quite a long time.
Okay.
I'm not a small person, a little boy.
Mm-hmm.
Even the tax that they were collecting for before even I paid 2.5 billion before it is pay my hospital, the university, the hotels, and the others.
Okay.
As I was telling Mr. Akpalu that he claimed that he's a citizen of this Ghana, this country, he's going to support the country, and the children are at overseas.
Mm-hmm.
And he's coming to rule something.
But he explained that. This is a matter that you've been.
And that one, he brought it. That is why I said that.
Okay, so you finished now, answering. Let me come to him. I don't have too much time.
Let him finish.
No, Mr. Andrews. I don't have too much
time. Go ahead.
So, Mr. Akpalu, I've asked the question that in the event of a runoff, you have mentioned that you win this election handsomely, massively.
But in the event that we go into a runoff, who are you supporting? This election.
Mm-hmm.
This is how it's going to be.
Mm-hmm.
There will be a runoff.
Mm-hmm. There will be a runoff?
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Then Nana Akufo-Addo will be first. I will be second.
I told you.
I will be second.
Mm-hmm.
Joe Mama will be third. Okay? And then the rest will follow.
So and then, this is after the runoff?
No. The first, before the runoff.
Before the runoff.
Yeah.
Okay, so the
runoff.
On December 7th, after
the runoff.
Vote,
mm-hmm. The runoff, I will win by 70%.
Okay.
Okay, so I want to prove to him, yeah? That he doesn't have the Holy Spirit inside him.
Oh.
Why? Where is this one?
Is that your conclusion?
I'm coming.
Is that your conclusion?
Because he's a damn liar.
No. Mr. Akpalu, I have children also watching the show.
Please.
You can't be calling people.
Hey, I'm serious.
You see, this man
claims to be a man of God. But I want to prove to him tonight that he's not a man of God.
You continue to be a liar because you're going to lie to the country.
You will not lie.
You are lying to the country.
Okay.
You are lying to the whole country.
That Akufo-Addo was going to rule for 8 years. Baumia will come after that.
Oh, for that one. What is your basis? What's your basis?
We have the video circulating on social media.
But
I've
already explained everything to you.
You've come back by saying that God has spoken to you to come and rule this country. It's not true.
Thank you very much.
Okay?
Thank you very much.
Not true.
God has not spoken to you. Were you there when God was speaking to you?
When was God speaking to me?
The result that I saw,
You saw?
Yes. I'm telling you. Because the result that I saw, he was last.
Okay.
A joker.
Okay. I can't wait for Parker Wilson's hotline documentary on prophecies and elections. But Mr. Ayaga, I'll give you the final word at this point. So I was asking about funding of your campaign, for instance. You've talked about how you're going to fund some of your policies. But in all, how are you funding your campaign quickly? And then also, in the event that there's a runoff, who are you supporting? NDC, NPP, or yourself?
It's very easy to fund a campaign if you're not involved in voting. if you are not involved in wastage and if you are not involved in corruption.
Okay.
We are not wasting our resources on billboards and a whole lot of things that you see printing of many unnecessary, what do you call it, papers all over the country.
Okay.
Making the whole country dirty. What is important is to be able to have your vehicle and you can fool them and get to the voter and tell them the policy.
So you're doing all this by yourself? You're doing all that by yourself?
I do that by myself.
Okay.
And then the party to help to work on the other. So we do that whatever.
Okay. And who are you supporting if in the event of a runoff?
Why do you ask me to support somebody and you're not asking if I am part of the runoff?
I also said that in the event of a runoff.
What I want you to understand is that nobody goes into an election to lose. Okay. Believing that it's going to lose. Nobody. Unless that
but the polls are not favorable to the APC.
The polls that people say are opinion polls.
Okay.
And people want to put actually that is a type political poll that I would come and say, oh, a pastor will come and say,
okay.
For instance, if I ask Pastor Chabuso to go out and say Hata Yerga is going to win the next election,
mm-hmm.
Pastor Otabel, go out and say Hata Yerga is going to win the election.
Okay, I really have to run at this point. I'm really out of time. Thank you so much, gentlemen, for joining us. Hassan Aiharanga, flag bearer of the APC. Mr. Andrews is also a Christian. Kwabena Andrews is the flag bearer of the Ghana Union Movement. And of course, Percival Kofi Akpaloo is the flag bearer of the Liberal Party Ghana. It's been quite a show tonight. Thank you very much for joining us on The Probe. I am MFA Power. Another edition next week. Okay, all right, number 8. Thank you so much.